Hello, Periscopers. Dr. Olivia Joseph here. And today I want to talk to you about the sunshine vitamin. Lord knows we don't have very much sunshine in the St. Louis area in February. This seems to be when we get snow and crummy weather and lots of cloudy days. And this is not about the weather, this is about your health. So what I want to talk to you about is vitamin D. Vitamin D deficiency is in just about every person who lives in the Midwest who is not taking vitamin D supplementation in the winter months. Now, vitamin D receptors are on every cell in your body. So if you have a vitamin D deficiency, it is affecting every cellular function in your body. Now, vitamin D protects your immune system, it protects your bones, and it actually acts like a hormone in your body, more so than even acting like a vitamin. Vitamin D has 2,000 functions in your body. So if you have a deficiency, it's a very big deal. The reason I'm even talking to you about it today is the most common thing that I get in my patients this time of year is, I just don't feel good. Elaborate on that. I'm tired all the time. I keep getting sick. I stay sick for long periods of time. I'm emotional. Sounds a lot like seasonal affective disorder, right? Well, what is seasonal affective disorder? It's a vitamin D deficiency. So how do you know if you're vitamin D deficient? It's a blood test. And this is the time of year, if you are not taking vitamin D, you need to have your vitamin D levels checked. Because if you had your levels checked in the summertime and they were normal, your levels are gonna be very, very different this time of year. Because vitamin D works like a savings account. You're making deposits all summer long. You don't need to take vitamin D in the summer months. Your body makes vitamin D. In 1 minute of direct sunlight without sunscreen on your large body parts, you will make 1,000 units per minute. So imagine if you're out in the sun for 20 minutes, 30 minutes without sunscreen, you're gonna make 20 to 30,000 units of vitamin D. It's why you feel great in the summer. That's why your energy is so good. It's why you don't get sick. So vitamin D makes deposits all summer long. And around October or November time, even though the weather can still be really nice in October and November, we're getting farther and farther from the sun. And if the sun isn't strong enough, and if our body parts are covered by clothing because it's the fall or the winter time, you cannot make vitamin D. Vitamin D deficiency is an epidemic, and vitamin D deficiency puts you at a higher risk for osteoporosis. So you need to have healthy vitamin D because your bones have vitamin D receptor sites. The biggest mistake I hear doctors telling their patients is to take calcium and vitamin D together. That doesn't make any sense because calcium is a mineral and vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin. So what you need to absorb vitamin D is vitamin K. So I do urge supplementing with vitamin D3. How much? It really depends on what your vitamin D levels are. I'm typically recommending 5,000 units daily of vitamin D3 to my patients November through March. When I'm monitoring my patients' blood levels, I want to see their vitamin D levels in the 60s because the Institute of Functional Medicine did a research study that showed when your vitamin D levels are in the 60s, your risk for 5 of the most common cancers goes down close to 70%. And those cancers tested in that clinical trial were breast cancer, prostate cancer, pancreatic cancer, stomach cancer, and colon cancer. Now, obviously, men aren't as high of risk for breast cancer, and women, we're not at risk for prostate cancer. But we have to make sure we protect our immune systems. The reason flu season starts in November is that's when vitamin D levels start dropping if you don't start supplementing in November. So that's typically what I'm recommending with my patients. But if you have a question, get a test. You don't even have to see your doctor to get a test. Quest owns a lab called Any Lab Now, and LabCorp also owns independent labs where you can self-pay like $25 to have your vitamin D levels checked. And if your vitamin D levels are below 30, you're deficient. If your vitamin D levels are below 20, you're going to have a tremendous amount of inflammation in your body, and your cells aren't going to be able to function properly because every cell has a vitamin D receptor. So we want to see vitamin D levels in the 60s because that's not just a normal range, that's the optimal range. Now, I also recommend supplementation with kiddos. This vitamin D3, 5,000 units, is what I use with my patients. But I also use a kid's D in a liquid, and this is about 400 units. And it depends on age, but children need vitamin D supplementation too. We're very, very deficient, and it affects our bones, our immune system, our hormone system. So vitamin D is really important, and I would encourage you to eat foods that are green and take vitamin D, because foods that are green are rich in vitamin K, and you need vitamin K because it's a fat-soluble vitamin in order to properly absorb vitamin D. So the number one thing I hear from my patients is, I just don't feel good. Well, a big part of that is because you've got a vitamin D deficiency, and we have to deal with that. Now, one thing I want to point out to you, if your doctor runs a vitamin D test on you and it turns out you're deficient and they prescribe vitamin D for you at 50,000 units per week, that prescription vitamin D is vitamin D2. Not vitamin D3. The problem is vitamin D2 does not absorb as well as vitamin D3. So your levels are going to go up a lot more slowly, okay? I recommend vitamin D3. It's more bioavailable, which means your body's going to absorb about 2/3 of it instead of just 1/3 of the D2. So have your levels monitored. I recommend having your vitamin D levels checked every winter as well as in the summer to make sure that your body's able to manufacture vitamin D properly in the summer months. And if you're not manufacturing vitamin D, then you might need supplementation year round. Another thing you want to know is if you've ever had a vitamin D deficiency in the past, chances are you're going to have it again. So once you develop a vitamin D deficiency one time and you correct it, if you don't regularly supplement with vitamin D and eat foods rich in vitamin K, which are your green foods, chances are it's going to happen again. So if you can't get sunshine because of the region that you live in, make sure you're monitoring your vitamin D levels and supplementing with vitamin D. Thank you, and I hope you guys get a little bit of sunshine.